Hunter stared down at the fingers on his sleeve, as if they were the most fascinating thing he'd ever seen.
I used to dream about this moment, you know. It's big, isn't it?
Kaori swallowed again, nodding slightly.
Yes, it is. I'm not the type of person who does this kind of thing casually. No, me neither. I've never felt this way about anyone before.
When Hunter looked up at him again, his gaze was very serious.
I will, you know, treat you with respect and courtesy.
Kaori thought he was literally going to break inside any second now.
I know you will.
He wasn't precisely sure how it happened or who initiated it, but his hand slid up to touch the side of Hunter's neck. Hunter's hand tightened over his waist to pull him closer, and then they were both leaning in to touch their mouths together in a kiss. The feel of Hunter's tongue against his was unexpectedly shocking, making Kaori shiver straight down to his toes.
Okay, Hunter whispered against his lips.
He was trembling too. Kaori nodded, unable to find the breath to speak. He moistened his lips, tasting the memory of Hunter's mouth there. Hunter's face was slightly stubbled, and the rasp of it against Kaori's skin was almost painful, but there was nothing about it that he would consider unpleasant. Closing his eyes, he leaned in to rub his cheek against Hunter's chin, wanting to feel more of it. Hunter's breath stuttered across his face as he leaned in to brush his lips across Kaori's cheek, his jaw.
I never thought you'd let me touch you like this, Hunter whispered.
Kaori shivered even deeper this time.
I never thought you'd want to,